Robert Miller died 6 weeks shy of his 80th birthday.
I'm just upset that his last 6 hours at home, in the home that we loved, was spent in agony.
David Terrelink says his husband suffered a fall at their home in Biggera Waters on June 11 and fractured his pelvis.
I first called the ambulance 000 at 9:30 in the morning. And I was told they were very busy.
It was the first of four phone calls to the Queensland Ambulance Service.
Desperate, pleading for an ambulance.
The service says it was experiencing higher than normal demand on the Gold Coast and remained in contact until paramedics could reach Robert.
He rated his pain on the pain scale of 1 to 10 as a 14.
The retired nurse says he felt helpless despite living 15 minutes away from two hospitals.
I couldn't get him in a wheelchair, I couldn't get him down to the car.
It took 6 hours for an ambulance to arrive. Robert was taken to the Gold Coast Private Hospital in a stable condition where he waited again.
He's wrapped for nearly 2 hours.
4 days later, he died in hospital.
He was elderly, he had other health issues. But the problem for me is he shouldn't have been made to suffer with elderly people. The longer you are in acute pain, it wears down your resolve. So I believe it contributed to his early death.
Stories like this are the reason why easier access has to occur.
It's clearly not good enough.
The Premier is also offering this advice.
If you're waiting for an ambulance, it's because our hardworking paramedics are dealing with more urgent cases.
David doesn't blame the health staff, but says he feels let down by the system, and that's why he's decided to speak out.
Those are my last memories of him at home, in pain. We had a wonderful life together for 24 years. We travelled well, we saw the world.
As he tries to come to terms with a world without him.